So we're here with the Africa Center. I am Jethro Rebollar of Caples, Jefferson Architects. And what we're looking at here is a projection into the future of what this space is going to become, which is a cultural center featuring a maker space for young adults. What we also have is a few gallery spaces for a Stanley Whitney to be showing his latest series. Whenever the General Assembly, the UN General Assembly is around, we have a kind of a cultural dignitary space. So instead of meeting at the local Regency Hotel, you can come down to the Africa Center and kind of be in your own space. And we're looking forward to it. It's going to be about 16 months for phase one, and then the terrace up that overlooks Central Park in the Harlem Mir, closer to 2019. We're all looking very forward to it. And to the audience, feel free to come on down.
Virtual reality is, so you walk in and it won't be a Starbucks. Like, we're keeping everything authentic, so it will be like, I personally have spent a lot of time in East Africa and working with the Rwandanese female coffee farmers that are now not just picking beans that they used to do and sell it to the middleman. They're actually manufacturing their own brand, so we will have that type of experience in our African cafe. Here would be an African market with things like this, authentic, but not just your sort of traditional what people expect of Africa. Like, there's so many African designers and whatnot. And then this space, this large atrium, will be open for whether it's, you know, a fashion show during Fashion Week, or we had lectures here, and this holds about 700 people when you open it all up. And then we can't, because and play that is doing experiments for children, and we will have also highlighting all of the new technologies on the continent. So real hands-on, technology experiences, things like a 3D printer, whatnot. So in this whole first floor will be open to the public, free. too often we have so many misperceptions and bad perceptions of the diaspora. So here we are on Fifth Avenue with one of the best views, about to enter Harlem from the Africa Center. So that just shuts it all down, in my opinion. I think about things like the marathon, right? The New York Marathon. This is the last, I think, 6 miles they come through here. And as you know, typically the first runners are African, and that's what's televised. So they're running through the Africa Center from Harlem on Fifth Avenue, you know, with views of the Africa Center, and that's what people will see. If you see our circle, there's a better view for it. Our circle, I'm going to put the 54 African flags, kind of like UN style, in the circle. So if you just think of the visual, like people viewing that, and, you know, with our great African athletes, you know, in the front, and that's what we see. This will also just be a break room for, you know, the African dignitaries. I'm sure some of them will smoke a cigar or something. You can't smoke in New York anymore. But this is just, if you just stop and take it all in and think about some of the stories that have been told and where we are and how significant this is. So we can go back out. We have a tent that will be covered, so this is all season. So this is, you can have a wedding, you can have a party, you can have a lecture. I think we could have a bat mitzvah at the Africa Center, right? Like, it's really starting to change the perception of the diaspora, right? Now you can envision the flag that I was talking about. This way.